Bonjour à tous. Donc je vais vous présenter cette
Good morning, everybody.
Magnifique table.
I'm going to introduce all the
là-bas,
people at this very impressive rostrum on the far end, David Thion, producer.
La comédienne Laure Calamy.
And the actress Laure Calamy.
Le comédien Gaspard Ulliel.
The actor Gaspard Ulliel.
Mademoiselle Virginie Efira.
Virginie Efira.
Le co-scénariste du film,
the
Arthur Harari.
Co-scriptwriter of the film, Arthur Harari.
La réalisatrice
the
Justine Triet.
Director, Justine Triet.
Mademoiselle Adèle Exarchopoulos.
Exarchopoulos.
Et messieurs Nils Schneider.
Nils Schneider.
Et Paul Amy.
And Paul Amy.
Alors, je vais commencer à faire une petite question
ask a first
à chacun.
Question.
Alors, vous allez me répondre de manière courte, hein, quand même, autrement, on va
give perhaps
on
a short answer.
Ensemble,
otherwise, we'll have to have lunch together.
Et après, il y aura
and then, of course,
sans doute quelques
we'll
questions,
take, questions from the journalists.
I'll begin par vous,
with you,
Justine Triet.
Justine Triet.
Pour ce film,
this film,
à tiroir et à thématique
with multiple
double,
levels and themes and doubles and all sorts of things.
Is this
the story of a young girl who doesn't really like herself and perhaps decides to reinvent herself in a way?
Oui, je pense qu'en tout cas,
yes, I believe in any event. That this talks about fiction and creation as a way of reinventing oneself.
Le personnage de qu'incarne Virginie Efira est dans un
the character played by Virginie Efira is in a state of denial in terms of her past and all sorts of things she can't contend with, the ghosts of her past. Indeed, fiction is a way for her
d'échapper à son quotidien.
To escape daily life.
Et alors bon, on va passer à la jeune femme qui échappe
we'll
à son quotidien, enfin qui essaie.
To the other female character.
Ce personnage qui,
this character
qui est double, qui fuit et qui en même temps finalement
sort of running away, who has two different personalities. She tries to escape into fiction, but then has to cope with her problems. Virginie Efira, how did you contend with the character?
J'avais trouvé une formule que je trouvais pas trop mauvaise hier, mais enfin.
I found a description that I thought was quite good. Someone said, how did you compose the character? I said, I don't know how I composed the character. It was more a question of decomposition.
With Justine,
in each scene, in fact, we didn't have the possibility, but the obligation to have about 45 takes. So I had to search in all sorts of different directions and create out of that a sort of a path or an avenue.
Sibylle
is trying to see
une action, un inconnu, un territoire qui la précède.
What she can find, she's trying a character, something that relates to the past, but which is totally new at the same time. So what I had to do was to really put myself in her shoes.
Pardon, vous dites quoi?
Parce que je crois qu'elle parle de ma voix.
I think she was talking about my voice. This press conference is taking place just the morning after a really good party last night. So if you understand what we say, it'll be quite miraculous. And then the person who, in fact, reveals the situation. It's you. It's Margot, this actress.
qui a se posé des questions sur la maternité.
Who asks all sorts of questions about being a mother and about creation.
Donc, ce double à la fois révélateur.
She is the other actress's double, the other character's double, in effect. They sort of reflect each other in the mirror. I think she is a woman who, in fact, is bound up in creation within herself, but she has a very complex relationship with Gaspard. And she absolutely wants to make the film. Virginie's character has all sorts of frustrations. She's haunted by ghosts, and my character is very porous and very narcissistic, very self-centered.
Il y avait, pardon, je
oui,
bah, oui. t'en prie. En fait, il y avait aussi l'idée
in
de,
fact,
de,
also, there was this idea that the film really showed how two people who are the total opposites come together. Virginia, in fact, you don't see who she really is throughout the film until the last third of the film. Then she appears as she actually is, and Margot does the absolute opposite. We have this sensation that she bears herself completely. In the course of the film, the character learns the codes of society, learns... to cope with that. So these two characters are so diametrically opposed. They depend on each other in the film. They're fascinated by each other. And then the two characters evolve in different directions, in opposite directions.
Oui, bien sûr, complètement.
Of course.
Il y a évidemment la tentation chez Sibylle de
Sibylle.
Venir chercher des choses qu'elle
is tempted to look for things
façon,
that
dire,
she feels and that spring from her own life, and she's looking for that in Margot. And then Margot actually then makes her think of her past love with Nils, with Gabriel, in fact, the character. And these two things gradually build up in the course of the film. And then we'll talk about the past, of course, this man who was very important
in real life.
Between the two, there is then Igor.
Est-ce que je peux me permettre de dire que Igor, c'est l'acteur?
Can I say that Igor is the actor?
Ce jeu constant avec le mensonge,
this constant playing with lies, the impression
si
that you never really
sincérité,
know whether
jeu,
the character
dans...
is sincere or whether he's just playing
ça,
around. Is that quite interesting to betray? You betray the part of an actor
constant, quoi. On est
who
en train de
is lying all the time. You really
vrai,
never know whether what he says is real. As Cocteau said, the cinema is a lie that tells the truth. Of course, what's the relationship between reality and fiction? One is constantly toying with that idea to find some kind of truth. I find it lots of fun, in fact, to be in a film in a film. To play a part, the part of someone who has the same profession as I do. What's really interesting in terms of what you said consisted in playing around with all these variations, these nuances. And as Virginie said, this is something Justine loves to do. We had a lot of choice, notwithstanding, but these choices are totally opposed. So we take lots and lots of takes and try different versions. Our ways of acting, we tried to make the character rather opaque. Sometimes he appears more brittle and more sincere, at other times he's manipulating people, and I think it's pretty successful. The editing is very successful. The film remains totally mysterious from beginning to end. There are two other men. There's the man of the past and the man of the present.
Vous incarnez celui qui a été
the man who was loved very much in the past, and you portray the man who's at home and who no longer is. It's very interesting. How did you go about these two male characters?
comme disait Virginie Gaspard,
well, as Virginie and Gaspard were saying, there were so many different takes, there are so many variations and nuances in the different scenes that I felt that Justine really managed to put together the character during the editing process.
Découvert au montage. Après, ce que je trouve,
you
discovered your character through the editing? Yes, absolutely.
Voilà.
That's what I wanted to say.
Et vous, Paul Ami, vous
and do you, Paul Ami, did you discover who you really are at the end? No, I knew who I was from the very beginning. I was a man who was a sort of a counterweight, who had to create a sort of a balance in this whole business. I am a sort of a pillar in the film, and I don't understand at all what's happening. But I'm very strong.
Non, mais c'est vrai que le film.
It's true. That the film.
Le film est impossible à comprendre.
It's impossible, really, to understand. When we shot it, it was impossible to understand. There were so many different facets to the characters, so many different bits and pieces here and there. People. The film was really created during the editing. And that's why people have the impression they discovered their characters very late on. There's another pillar,
assez piquant quand même,
but quite
an
exciting one. It's the sister.
Et alors vous êtes ce rapport avec l'héroïne.
You have a special relationship with the heroine, and sometimes you say very true things to her. But you come across as rather nasty, as a bit mean. You're very realistic in the mean sense of the word. You state things the way they are. Your part is more openly funny. Given your lines, for example. You're sort of the palm reader. Yes, you predict the misfortunes. Absolutely. My character is very good at telling people home truths. She's less good when it comes to herself.
Pour se sauver enfin de la toxicité de leur mère hein,
voilà she tries to save her from
voilà chacune différemment
the mother and what they inherited for the mother but at the same time the character is sort of destroyed by that at the same time. She's part of the hidden dimension of Sibyl. This hidden dimension that she tries to bury all the time, but she keeps peeking out in the film. Adèle triggers many things, this toxic family, all the lies in the family.
En revenant avec ce côté trivial, plus impur, c'est toute cette part-là.
Adèle has this trivial, more impure side.
Très important selon moi. Dans
and Laure, I think, conveys a lot and portrays some very important things in the film in terms of Sibyl's background.
Alors maintenant qu'on a vu à quel point tout ça.
Now that we've seen to what extent this is very complex, it's like a mosaic, in fact. I'd like to turn to the scriptwriter. How do you write
avec Justine Trier et que
with Justine Trier?
Elle arrive en disant voilà, je veux parler de tout ça, ben on va se
did she say, well, I want to talk about all this and do your best? Well, I'm not the script writer of the film with Justine. It's Justine who really writes her films. I just help her.
Donc le film a une dimension relativement complexe et chaotique.
It's quite complex and chaotic.
Et encore, c'est vraiment rien du tout.
And that's nothing, in fact, compared with the writing of the film.
Les murs étaient couverts de post-it.
At one point, the walls were covered with post-its.
C'est-à-dire qu'on to an amazing extent. Un jeu entre la subjectivité
we were playing around
de Sibyl,
with the
Margot,
subjectivity of Sibyl and that of Adèle. All these souvenirs, which may not be real memories, but may just be fantasies. And this is all intertwined in the writing. The images you see may be just pure fiction. It was highly complex and extreme to write this. I have the impression that I played a minor part just discussing all these things together. Because, of course, when writing, you have to talk about things. The idea was to try
un chemin à cette chaos-là qui
trace out some path in this overall chaos.
Que le film se construise comme ça.
That's how the film was structured and built.
Il fallait trouver une harmonie, mais
yet at the same time we had to find some kind of a harmony.
L'écriture s'est poursuivie au montage et
writing continued during the actual editing, and it's quite outstanding what they managed to do.
Simultanément, la sensation d'une
you have the impression that the film is totally chaotic,
un labyrinthe,
a sort of a labyrinth. Yet it's crystal clear at the same time. That's quite prodigious.
Aussi pour organiser ce chaos, enfin tenter de le faire.
And you tried to organize all this chaos.
Le psy de la psy.
You were the psychiatrist of the psychiatrist. Yes, it was really funny.
Oui. J'ai d'une certaine manière.
Yes, to a degree in the film, one can say that I played the part I play at home, well at least on the set.
Et oui, avec ce côté presque.
Yes, I would agree with what you say.
On peut dire que chaque personnage du film.
Each character in the film
est une projection intérieure.
Is a kind of projection of Virginie, of Sibyl, I beg your pardon.
Donc plutôt de Justine.
Or rather Justine, maybe.
C'est très simple, on le voit.
It's very simple, as you can see.
Le personnage du psy que je joue est aussi une
facette. The character, the psychiatrist, is kind of a facet. It's a bit like in Tintin, where Milou says, don't drink, it's alcohol, and then someone else says, oh, drink. And I was there, and I tried to say, don't cross the line. You know full well that there are certain ethics, rules, which lay down the fact you shouldn't be doing this or that.
David Thion, avec ça, là.
David Thion. How does one produce this kind of film when there are post-its that plaster an entire wall? Well, the driving force, basically, was the very strong conviction that we were working with a very great director. We'd worked with her on previous films. She has an outstanding talent. That was the first driving force. And then it was something of a challenge. We didn't have much time. Justine, when she gave me the first version of the script, it was already August, and we had to start the shooting next April. So we didn't have much time. And the screenplay, the script, as Arthur said, it was lengthy, it was complicated, it was complex. That was what was really exciting for me, but rather difficult. We had to move forward, we had to find money for the film, we had to bring together a technical crew, we had to find the actors and actresses, while the script was evolving constantly. Usually, at one point in time, the script is ready, it's just, it's been done, and then you shoot and edit. But in this case, the script was being recreated all the time. A question?
Hi, I'm David from Movieview China. My question is for Justine. Mika is a director in the film. I was wondering, did you draw inspiration from yourself to creating this character?
Yes.
And also, is it because of Tony Erdmann you want to work with Sandra?
Effectivement, j'ai adoré Sandra Hüller dans Tony Erdmann.
Yes. I loved Tony Erdmann, and I saw the actor in that film, the actress in that film. I had very positive memories. Quite frankly,
inconscient très forte, mais j'aime vraiment trop la fiction, donc
I love fiction.
Sûrement qu'il y a des choses de moi dedans, mais ce n'est pas
probably bits of myself in it, but it's not a self-portrait after all.
Je m'inspire de choses qui viennent de mon
entourage, de moi, mais c'est pas from my life, from my surroundings and the people I know.
Je suis pas dans une situation aussi catastrophique qu'elle dans la vie.
But of course, I'm not in such a desperate situation as she is in life. So quite frankly,
c'est un mélange de plein de choses.
It's a mixture of all sorts of things.
J'ai pas vraiment de fascination pour l'idée même de l'autofiction.
I'm not really fascinated by the idea of self-fiction.
J'aime l'idée de me cacher.
I like the idea of hiding.
De moi caché dans une narration comme ça.
There's a hidden aspect of myself to this very complex film, and I like the idea that it remains hidden.
Sandra, peut-être qu'il y a des petites choses. Je pense que les actrices ont, on a vu peut-être plus de.
Maybe the actresses found more commonalities between me and the characters.
Madame, oui.
Good morning. My name is Vanessa. I'm from Hong Kong. I have two questions. First is for Justine. Since you said this is not a self-reflecting movie, so and I believe that all the directors, when they want to do a movie, that's a mission. Either it's for themselves or it's for the generation or to documentary something. So well, what was your mission during this movie?
Plein de réalisateurs se fixent une mission, soit pour eux-mêmes, soit pour leur génération, soit pour le monde ou quoi. Est-ce que tu t'étais fixé une mission?
Tout simplement, quelle était ta mission, Justine?
I had two questions. The second question is for... You can answer first. Yeah, thanks, thank you.
Non, honnêtement, je me...
Well, quite frankly...
Enfin, pour moi, écrire des films, faire des films...
For me, making a film...
Je ne peux pas penser aux conséquences...
Well, I never think of the consequences.
Pas penser en écrivant à ça.
When I write
a
film, I don't think I'm being a militant. I'm not trying to uphold a given cause. But when I see the films I make, maybe you can analyze them in that way. However, it's not a driving force for me. I don't think you make a good film if you feel you're invested with some kind of a mission. That's not the way I approach things.
Okay, so the second question is more for the actors and actress. I heard that you have many, many takes. And I've done some acting before. I know how it feels when you have many, many takes. That what's that at some moments that you guys was like doubting what the director won or the director's waiting for you to get into emotions? Like, it's a special emotion. The director's expecting you guys to get in. That's why she needs many, many takes. Or what is the reason behind it?
Je commence à répondre. Non, alors absolument pas parce qu'elle.
Well, not at all.
C'est pas l'idée de dire merde, je sais pas exactement ce que je veux faire. C'est l'idée d'étendre le domaine.
It's not the idea I don't know exactly what I should do. It's a question of opening up the full range of possibilities. That's the way we work with Justine on the film.
Là, et moi, ce qui m'a vraiment assez plu en découvrant le film, c'est que Justine, je trouve qu'elle a gardé film, cette espèce de chose chaotique. C'est quelqu'un qui dérange elle-même sur un plateau son propre film.
And she upsets her own film when she's on the set, in a sense. She brings out things that are just beyond the actors.
L'usure en étant aussi,
wear and tear is one of the means to achieve this. It's fine, we're all a bit masochistic.
Le fait de faire d'aller vers une forme de d'épuisement produit quelque chose.
That we started to get exhausted, produce something in fact.
And with the CD, par rapport à
there was this real issue in terms of Victoria to have the right frame, the right form.
And compared with Victoria,
I think that in this film we had to have this chaos and all sorts of things came in from the outside world to feed the storyline. What we tried to do is to frame things, to control the situations, but to create total chaos, notwithstanding. That was a real achievement.
On a envie de ça sur tous les films, en fait.
We'd like to have this kind of situation in all the films, looking for different things throughout the shooting. And Adèle, what about for you?
Vous avez la même impression de ça?
Did you have the same impression?
Très bien répondu.
Ouais. Pour moi, 30 prises, c'est pas beaucoup, du coup.
I think the answer is pretty complete.
Puis surtout que quand c'est une forme d'exigence de demander à ces acteurs de nuancer.
It's quite demanding to ask actors to be very nuanced in their performance. Virginie had constantly to create. But that's what I expect. I like people to be demanding.
C'est vrai que it's true
there's something that happens over time. It's not necessarily the takes that we keep and the editing that count the most.
Certitude au moment du tournage.
When you shoot, you have all sorts of certainties, but then when you do the editing, you're not sure of anything more. After all,
c'est vraiment, il suffit qu'il y ait marqué que ce soit la meilleure prise pour que ce soit absolument pas celle qu'on prend.
If I say this is the best take, probably in the end it's the one we won't keep. So I think it's very essential to keep looking together and to move in different directions in terms of love, darkness, and we all are involved in this quest together. Each actor is different. Adèle and Virginie are quite amazing in the sense that they're so different when acting. I need all this time, in fact, during
the shooting.
Okay, people keep saying, well, you just have to relax, let go. I love all these takes when the actors are in extreme situations. Okay, you often have the feeling that this prise is the best, but sometimes I like the one that just follows, because the faces are more marked by emotion and convey absolutely everything, and the actor is just optimal. So it's something quite physical, it's quite organic. If you don't take these risks, I get the feeling that you limit yourself to what the actor is offering, but I don't know how to put it. You don't have this magical thing, this magical ingredient.
When we
go outside the script, okay, the script is great, but sometimes you have to go outside the script to find what's perfect.
I'm here. You made the film with a complicated relationship, psychology relationship, relationship, for example, are like on TV show. I mean, many levels film have. I mean, they could be developed from series to series. And my question is, how do you feel about TV series? TV series, the future of the film industry? And the question for all, Gaspar, Adele.
Oui, bah j'ai l'introduction. donc les séries télé.
TV series.
C'est très simple.
Quite
moi,
honestly, it's very simple for me. Like most people,
énormément de séries.
I love watching series on TV.
Effectivement, le fait de regarder autant de séries fait que.
Maybe it's because I watch so many series.
D'aisance, de facilité comme ça, avoir des films avec énormément de personnages.
I like films with lots and lots of characters, films that are really complex.
Je fais avec le monde dans lequel on est, je trouve
of
ça.
Of course, I just cope with the world as it is.
Je ne vais pas dire voilà le cinéma contre la série.
I'm not trying to say that films are the opposite of series. I love series as I love films.
Très mauvaise, qui même la majorité. Mais
a lot of series are really bad, of course, but in terms of what you're actually talking about, i.e.
personnages secondaires extrêmement
these secondary characters, which are really important, the more minor roles. In the major series, there are all sorts of examples of this, and that, of course, has helped to flesh out my work.
Carlos Carrasco from La Razón, La Paz, Bolivia. I have a straight question. How long did it take the making of this film? And the second one is an indiscreet question. How much did it cost?
David.
David. Alors le tournage, je crois. Alors moi, on a eu des. Combien? 40, un peu moins de 40 jours, je crois.
We had just under 40 days. I can't really remember. I think it was about 40 days.
It's always too short and never enough money.
Merci, Gaspard. Non, mais effectivement, en plus, on a dû couper pas mal de pages.
Hein. We had to cut out quite a lot of pages because we got less money than expected. The cost, well, you know that, David.
Avec les coups de canne ou sans les coups de canne?
The costs all included?
Aux alentours de un petit peu plus de 5 millions.
Just over 5 million.
D'euros.
Euros.
5 millions de jours.
5 million days. 5
millions de jours.
Of shooting. And 40 euros of budget.
Ah, moi, je voudrais vous reposer une question.
To ask you a question.
Non, c'est ridicule de dire il y a deux
it's
parties.
It's ridiculous to say that there are two parts. But there is this moment in the film when they start shooting a film. They're in Italy.
La direction artistique qui change un peu dans le film, quelque chose de plus éclatant, tout ça.
The casting is quite striking. The set as well.
Il y a un point d'ironie. On a constamment l'impression.
But there is an element of irony in the film. The idea of passionate love, this couple.
Subtil dans le pastiche.
But, c'est quand même it's very subtle. Pastiche. It turns into a sort of a pastiche.
Oui, je pense a Stromboli.
Non, mais c'est sûr que c'est
Stromboli. Yes, that's the part of the film that's most satirical, in fact.
Je m'amuse de plein de choses. Et
I
C'est le moment où finalement
play around with all sorts of amusing things, and everything echoes everything else. Margot herself is living a kind of a tragedy.
Tournant ce mélo avec son mec, etc. C'est
the film is melodramatic. She's in the film with her guy. I push this quite far, much more so than in the first part of the film, which is first degree. It's a lot of things happen in people's minds. It's linked to the idea of the impure side of the film, and the film sort of takes off in Stromboli. It's full of satire. The idea is to make fun of the idea of shooting a film.
Très jubilatoire à écrire.
Of course, it's lots and lots of fun to write a film in this manner. I had lots of fun in the scenes where Gaspar is singing. Obviously, we pushed back the limits. We had lots of fun playing around with this.
Le personnage de Sibylle qui devient une espèce de Paula Strasberg.
She becomes a sort of a Paula Strasberg, Marilyn Monroe of the film. Is this a way of paying tribute to these people, to the psychiatrists who become absolutely obligatory advisors? She says to Marilyn, this.
Pendant le tournage, ne s'adressait plus à John Ford.
The shoot is really good. There's a reference to a number of well-known directors, and
cette chose un peu étrange de cette
it's a bit strange to see these people suddenly being brought into the film. It inspired me no end during the actual shooting.
My name is Aya Koishizu for Movie Plus Japan. Well, question for Gaspar and director Justine and. Well, in a film, so you're singing the canzone, the Buongiorno Trieste. Well, I don't know that. Well, it reminds. Well, it keeps in my head, you know, repeating until now. So, how do you prepare for the singing thing? But I didn't know you were the great singer until now.
Oh, really?
That was great.
Well, thanks. for me, it was like a stunt, really. Because I have like a real, really big fear of singing. Maybe it's because of my mom who always told me I was the worst singer in the world. But so
when Justine m'a parlé de cette scène la première fois, Justine talked to me about this scene the first time round, I said, no, it's going to be totally impossible. But she managed to convince me. I don't know how she achieved that. You remember that I was singing at the same time as you were?
Oui, pour répondre à la question.
Yes, so to answer your question.
J'ai suivi quelques rapide cours de
I took some singing lessons in Paris. I saw a teacher 4 or 5 times.
Et puis ensuite, on a tourné cette séquence.
And then we shot the scene.
Et après, Justine avait décidé de me doubler.
Afterwards, Justine decided to rope in a real singer, and I slept much better at night. During the post-synchronization, I had the amazing surprise of seeing me doing the song, because Justine at the last minute decided that I should be the one doing the singing. It's a beautiful song. I'm very sorry. Our time is up.
The film will faire poser plein de questions, donc.
We'll raise any number of further questions. Thank you very much. Merci.